Guys!
Hi. Ciao ragazzi, tutte ragazze. Come stai? Bene? Bene. So, in this video, we're going to be talking something more about the fuel pump. Just a quick update video on fuel pump when it fails. When something there fails, and if you should replace the fuel pump, the whole pump, or not. So, let's see that video. Shall we? This is the fuel pump for Mercedes-Benz. And it's not compatible only with the 230E, my model. It's compatible with all kind of other cars, not just Audi. So let me give you its reference number. It says 0580464125. And then you can see for yourselves, as you see it like this. So here, this is for its connections, positive and negative. And this is the non-return valve. Now, why am I saying that? There are stories that people say the fuel pump should never be replaced. You just replace the non-return valve and that's everything. Well, I disagree. I disagree partially. Let's say with that. If your fuel pump lost pressure over time, it is going to give you less pressure. And if it supplies 5 bar instead of 6, well, then, okay, the engine is going to be working, but with 4.6 bar control pressure, well, your car is going to run, but you're going to have a huge fuel consumption. And if the pump delivers the quantity of fuel you need, then it can be up to the non-return valve, because as the fuel enters here, this feed line, how they call that, this valve does its job, what it says. It prevents fuel not to get back. So, but to flow further. Sometimes maybe you have a leaky washer, as it was my case, and as for me, I still keep that old fuel pump, and I am going to test it once. It can happen that this non-return valve dies, that it fails. And then how can you check if it failed or not? You can just attach the pressure gauge on your fuel distributor. Here at the lower chamber of the fuel distributor, you can start the car. And after you run the car, of course, when it's warm, and you stall the car, if this needle falls, so if this needle was showing about 5.5 bar pressure, and it, as you stall the car, it falls rapidly in a second, in a fraction of a second, to 0 bar, then you should know that you have a faulty non-return valve, and you can simply replace the valve itself, and you don't have to buy the new pump. But if the pump is capable of delivering the required pressure, then it's okay. Then why should you replace the pump? You can just replace the valve, and that's it. If the fuel pressure starts falling as you stall the car, if the fuel pressure starts falling slowly, something like this, then the first thing for you to check would be the fuel pressure regulator. This thing. So, if you're sure that you have replaced the fuel filter and you don't have a stable, constant, steady pressure, then it's up to the fuel pressure regulator, because its task is to maintain a constant pressure, which is created by the pump. And that would be it, or as French people say, c'est ça. So my dear ones, if you enjoyed this video, then please don't click the button skip ad. It is going to help me a lot. And till the next video, happy Mercedesing. Bye.